Yeah. Okay. But, hang on. We got to talk about Khashoggi. Tell me about this guy, this Saudi citizen that's been disappeared.
I'm always amazed how the media just stops doing any kind of journalism. Like I see the stories they're writing, and I'm like, this is not what I would be writing about at all. For one, yes, this is like a Quentin Tarantino style movie.
It's amazing.
It really is.
Yeah.
I absolutely think the Saudis are guilty on this. I think Turkey is probably overplaying what they do have, probably just a little bit, because they hate the Saudis. But everyone's framing this journalist Khashoggi as this great guy,
Nobel Prize winning.
Oh yeah,
you know, he'll be a Nobel Peace Prize winner soon.
He came up, so surprise, surprise, he really came into prominence. The media loved him. The West loved him during the Obama administration. Why was that? Because, well, he was one of these ones advocating for democracy in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia and other places when the Arab Spring was breaking out.
Mm-hmm.
Now, that lines up exactly what the Obama administration was wanting to do. And also, who were they in bed with? The Muslim Brotherhood in places like Egypt. Well, surprise, surprise, Khashoggi is Muslim Brotherhood. That's the reason why he's not in. The people in the media have said, oh, well, he spoke out against, you know, the kingdom, the Saudi kingdom, and that's probably why they didn't like him. No kidding, but it goes way beyond that. Like, they support a political Islam group that wants to overthrow the monarchy. It goes a lot further than, oh yeah, he spoke out against them. Yeah, he is I wouldn't say public enemy number one, but he's right up in that group with them.
He was friends with the crown prince, though, was he not?
That's
how they're framing it. He was friends. He loved the crown prince. They got along, and he said a lot of great things about the crown prince. Now he disagrees with some of the crown prince's policies, and that's where they've
wants to take the Saudi out of Saudi Arabia, basically. That's the best way to put it for this guy. But he's not a good guy. He wants political Islam. He wants political Islam to invade countries all over the world and take it over. And he was living here for quite a while before he went to Turkey.
Oh, working at the Washington Post.
So, yeah, no issues there whatsoever. On the other hand, so you have this one guy that's not that great of a guy. Then on the other hand, you have Mohammed bin Salman, the crown prince, who everyone is saying, this is this great reformer. He's a great guy. He's a great leader. He's going to modernize Saudi Arabia. Women can drive now. All these social issues he's tackling. He's a thug. Plain and simple, he is a thug. They go after, he's doing this to tons and tons of people, thousands of people in his own country. People just disappear. They go to jail for the rest of their lives. He is a thug. And the only reason he's tackling social issues is because they have a lot of young people in Saudi Arabia, and social unrest is about to hit the street. If you want to see the place where the next Arab Spring might happen, Saudi Arabia. The demographics point to it. I would not be surprised.
Right.
At all.
So how do you keep Saudi Arabia under control, though, without a thug?
You can't.
I mean,
it's like Russia, really.
Yeah. Right.
Groups like countries like that, you really can't.
Here's the disturbing part. Most likely, this guy was killed by Saudi Arabia.
Yeah.
It just feels like, man, maybe all of a sudden he pops up and I was like, no, I was at Chick-fil-A and nobody in the media wants to look at Chick-fil-A. So I was invisible for a while. Maybe. Doubtful. Here's the problem. We are pushing through a major arms deal with Saudi Arabia. We should not be doing that.
Nope.
We should not be doing that.
That should be canceled today.
I can tell you, however, what is happening is, you know, the United States was supporting the Muslim Brotherhood. Now we have some people who know exactly what's going on in that part of the world, and they're probably being talked to by Saudi Arabia going, look, guys, yeah, I know you don't like what we're doing here, but it's a Muslim Brotherhood and it's a caliphate. You want the whole region to be in a Muslim Brotherhood caliphate? Have at it.
Yeah.
And that's the decision our president is having to make. It's why we should stay out of other people's businesses.
Amen.
Stay out of their business.